Bendy and the Ink Machine is an episodic survival horror video game that initially came out on Steam. It follows the tale of Henry Stein, a retired animator who returns to his old studio after he receives an invitation to do so from his ex-employer. There, he discovers the Ink Machine at the studio has brought to life a nightmarish slew of cartoon characters. The game is officially out on console platforms. So today, as you guys dive into the game, we're diving into some Easter eggs that you should look out for while you play. All to give yourself some more scares if you so choose. This is our list of the top 10 scary Easter eggs in Bendy and the Ink Machine. Starting us off in at number 10, Sammy's voice. While we never fully get to see Sammy Lawrence in the game, we do hear a whole lot of his voice. Makes sense, considering his main shtick was to write songs. He was the music department director at Joey Drew Studios. Various audio logs can be heard in the game with Sammy's voice in them too. But there's also an Easter egg in Chapter 3 that contains his voice that's especially creepy. If you go to the hallway close to level 11, where the music radio is, there are a bunch of instruments just lying around. If you interact with the instruments in a specific order, you'll hear an audio log play in which Sammy says, "We've all been waiting, but now he will set us free." In order to hear it, you gotta hit the bass fiddle, then the drum, then the violin, then the piano, and lastly the drum again. Moving on to number 9, the Meatly. Throughout the game, there's a series of hidden rooms that you can find that contain this stick figure, the Meatly. Who's that? Well, the Meatly is actually the lead creator of Bendy and the Ink Machine, in real life. He's the founder of the game dev company Kindly Beast, and he's also a comic illustrator and puppeteer. His real name is unknown, he just goes by the Meatly, and he's now online for his stick figure caricature. Anywho, in Chapter 1, you'll see the Meatly stick figure at the end of this hallway with a blank stare on its face, and Henry will say, "What the hell is that?" It continues throughout the other chapters in the game too, always existing behind this same poster, but only accessible after you've done something specific to trigger it. While it may seem like a really cool Easter egg, when you do find the Meatly in the game initially, his presence can be quite haunting, at least for a moment. And at number 8, the Ink Machine. While the Ink Machine is most prominent in Chapter 1, it constantly reappears in the game as an Easter egg, appearing for a split second, being lowered on chains into darkness. Now in Chapter 2, you can see it behind the bars on the right from the hallway in between the ink pool and the ritual room. Then in Chapter 3, you can see it behind the bars on the right from the trailer room. Then in Chapter 4, the Ink Machine appears in the distance in the spiral stairway, but only after you've encountered the flashing hallucination of hands coming from the walls. And if you've never played this game, all of those things might sound batshit crazy, but hey, it's definitely worth the play. And at number 7, the jump scares. This game has no shortage of jump scares. In Chapter 1, Bendy has one particular jump scare that had players freaked out. After you start the task of collecting all the items, there's a door next to Wally Frank's office that you can interact with. Now, if you attempt to open it, this will trigger the Bendy jump scare. Take a look, guys. Speaking of jump scares, and at number 6, Sammy's jump scare. Bendy isn't the only one delivering unexpected frights. In Chapter 2, the old song, if you go to the first place where you encounter Sammy, and stand next to the wall with the Bendy cutout that's right there, you can hear the sound of Sammy talking within the wall. He says, "In the morning, you may awake in the morning, you will be dead." Yeah, pretty creepy when you're just standing there and not expecting it. And at number 5, Sammy's shadow. We got some more creepy Sammy Lawrence for you in at this number. Now in Chapter 2, after you've unlocked the entrance to the flooded sewers, don't enter them just yet. If you look behind the bars opposite to the entrance, you will see a terrifying sight. It's a shadow of Sammy Lawrence standing in behind the bars. Now, after you retrieve the second valve and leave the sewers, shadow will completely disappear altogether. And at number 4, the whistling. In Chapter 2, in the part with the ink flooded room, right before Ink Bendy pops up, if you turn around and walk backwards towards the door down the hallway, you'll trigger this particular audio event. While standing next to the door, you'll hear the sound of the ink machine running. And if you wait for about 40 seconds in idle, you'll hear the same whistling that appeared in the Chapter 2 and later the Chapter 5 trailers for the game. Now remember, you'll need to walk backwards in order to prevent Ink Bendy from popping up. Otherwise, you're not gonna hear this. And at number 3, screams. There's an organ in the first room to the right in the entrance of the hallway. If you play the keys on the organ, there's a faint moaning scream that can be heard. If you do this 5 times, you'll actually get an achievement called Johnny's Broken Heart. Check it out. Moving on to number 2, the projector. This one's my personal favorite. So, in chapter 2 in the recording studio, every time you play the projector, a bendy cutout will appear on the stage. Now up to 9 of them will populate that stage. Now when you go down to the stage and look up to where the projector is afterwards, you'll see them all up there, looking down at you. It's incredibly spooky. And finally, in our number 1 spot, Wandering Sin. Throughout the game, Bendy and his happy demeanor become more and more haunting. Often you'll notice that whenever you destroy the cardboard cutouts of Bendy and then turn back around, you'll see that the cardboard cutouts have been repaired. They're there in perfect condition. It's really eerie. But there's an Easter egg that takes that to the next step. If you ever glitch or teleport to a normally inaccessible area of the game, you'll see a very creepy looking version of Bendy, specifically the Bendy cardboard cutout. Except, it's got age stains on it. There's ink leaking from its eyes and mouth, along with a pentagram behind him, suggesting that the cutout is demonically possessed. He'll be holding a sign that reads, "Wandering is a terrible sin." Alright, there we have it, friends. Have you guys played Bendy and the Ink Machine yet? Has it scared the crap out of you? Or were you loving the old school animation influences and just kind of enjoyed it? Let us know in those comments below. If you guys dug this video, spread that love, hit that like button. And don't forget to subscribe if you're new. In the meantime though, thanks for watching, everybody. I'll catch you on the next video.